Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day. And welcome to today's video, which is a product review for the Suaoki 300 watt power inverter. Now, it is an inverter which will take your 12 volt DC battery voltage and convert this into a 240 volt nominal 50 hertz power supply with a 300 watt rating. If you're not familiar with power inverters, there are basically two types. One is a pure sine wave and the other is a modified sine wave. Now this particular one is the modified sine wave. The difference between the two is the pure sine wave is really just the emulation of the household current. So you've got 240 volts, 50 hertz with a pure sine wave output. So that's 240 volt root mean square and something like 350 volt peak on that sine wave. With the modified sine wave type, the inverter almost produces a square wave, and by some clever manipulation using capacitors and inductors, we can eliminate and add some of the harmonics to give you a stepped output rather than a square wave. As you can see on screen now, this is the output from this particular modified sine wave inverter. It's not an actual square wave. You can see there's two steps on the waveform. There are inverters which have got more steps in, but they cost far more than this product does. The only disadvantage in using modified sine wave inverters is when you've got things like motors which have got a need for a pure sine wave. Otherwise you get a hum or buzzing with the effect. Because you're using an almost DC power supply, some motors, because of their impedance, will run a lot hotter than they would if they were running on a sine wave. So if you've got an application which has got a motor or a transformer, then it's not recommended that you use modified sine wave devices because of the overheating effect that these might have with transformers and motors. You've also got the problem of startup current with inductive devices. Something like a 300 watt continuously rated fan would also have a 2 to 3 times startup current, maybe 900 watt startup current before the fan runs in its continuous mode. So again, you've got to factor that in when you're considering these power supplies. Let's have a closer look at this Suaoki power inverter. It's a neat little unit, measures something like 5 inches deep, 2 inches high and 3 inches wide, and it weighs about a pound and a half. On the input side, you've got 2 4mm binding posts and the supply cables. One's the usual cigar lighter, which again you would attach to the binding post. So the positive lead and the negative lead will go to the binding post, and then you would screw on the clamps to make sure you've got a real tight connection. With the cigar lighter, you are limited to about 100 watts power because of the amount of current that you draw from the car circuit. If you want to work out what the actual current from the battery or the car circuit would be, if you take the AC wattage, divide that by 12 and then multiply it by 1.1, you'll get a fair idea of the amount of current. If you were, for example, using a 300 watt load, a 300 watt continuous load with this inverter, you'd need to use the supply cables which have got the battery clips. If you take the 300 watts, divide that by 12 and multiply it by 1.1, you're looking at in the order of 28 amps from your battery to power that 300 watt continuous load. In my opinion, the cable supplied with this inverter isn't adequate for 300 watts. You're going to be drawing 28 amps on this cable, and I don't think that's rated for 28 amps. It's probably rated up to about 15 or 18 amps. On 28 amps continuously, this cable is going to get hot, and these connections here on the clips are not really rated for that amount of current. So I would say if you're going to use this type of inverter, you're going to limit yourself to about 150 watts running on the battery clips or on the cigar lighter to be on the safe side. On the output side of the unit, you notice here for the UK unit, we've got the 3-pin 1363 type socket. The unit itself is overcurrent protected, so if you try to draw more than the maximum current this is allowed, it will shut down, give you an audio warning, and then shut down. The two USB outputs are powered continuously whilst this device is either plugged into the cigar lighter or attached to your battery with the supplied cables. So they are live all the time. You don't need this unit to be turned on to use the USB outputs. And both of those are rated at 2.1 amps. I did some technical measurements of this unit just to prove the specifications. You see them on screen now. The actual frequency of this unit from no load to full load was within the specified frequency of 50 hertz plus or minus 1 hertz, so it was keeping frequency. The actual voltage fluctuated from 230 to 243, dependent on the type of load you had on it. And I use this on the car, attached to the battery, to drive a 120-watt tungsten light. You can see on screen now, that drew something like 10 amps from the battery, giving me a 120-watt output on the meter. The unit is fairly intelligent. If you're using this without the car alternator being used to provide backup power to the battery, and if you're going to use it for that 300-watt load, I do presume you're going to use the alternator to provide secondary power to the battery, as with 30-amp load, it's going to deplete your battery within half an hour. So you need to have the car running if you want to use that full 300-watt rating. If you're using it on the battery alone and not using the alternator as backup, then the device will shut down if the battery drops below 10.5 volts. So it prevents the battery from being too discharged, so that you're not going to have problems starting the car afterwards. Also, if it runs over 14.5 volts, the unit will shut down to prevent damage to the inverter if the battery voltage or the alternator voltage exceeds 14.5 volts. So it's fairly well protected for under and over input voltage and over current output, so it will be okay in that respect. When the unit is turned on, the little fan in the back of the unit runs continuously to keep the electronics cool. It's not loud, it's a nice whisper quiet motor, but it does keep the unit cool. If you are using this unit for high wattage loads, you'll notice that the unit does run slightly warm, but again it will shut down if it exceeds the recommended temperature within the unit of 40 degrees centigrade. The uses for these inverters these days is becoming less, as more and more devices are either 12 volt operated and you can run them directly for the car, or are USB powered, so you can use a 12 volt to USB adapter. It's useful in cases where you don't have that facility of a 12 volt or USB input. Some of the camera battery chargers are only 240 volt input, so again you could use this to charge batteries. For example, some of the Panasonic battery chargers for cameras, and indeed some of the Canon, don't have the 12 volt input to enable you to charge your battery. So you've got to use them from a 240 volt supply. And I've used a similar unit in car with a 4-way adapter to charge my camera batteries on traveling from location to location. So they are handy for those sort of things. This is ideal for small appliances. It won't run things like curling tongs or hair dryers. It is ideally for wattages. Below the 200 watts I would recommend if you're going to use the supply cable. In my opinion, I would recommend that you use 200 watts as the maximum continuous rating for this, especially if you're going to be using the battery cables that are supplied with it. I don't think these are adequately rated for that 28 amps that you would need if you were going to run this at full output power. So there we are, that's my technical evaluation of this Suaoki 300 watt power inverter. I'll put a link in the video description below so you can have a look at the full technical specification on the Amazon webpage, and you can see the current UK price for this item. So that's it for this video. Thanks very much for watching. Until my next review, please do take care, and I'll see you then. Goodbye for now.